are listening to Serenity Radio Network on Jerry Royce Live Worldwide at positivepower21.org. We thank you for joining us. You can also find us on Elation Radio. Serenity is a Christian-based multicultural empowerment station that focuses on the mind, body, and spirit. The program specializes in bringing to the listeners the very best from the healing arts community on the subjects of self, health care, spiritual healing, and kingdom living. Serenity Radio is sponsored by the Serenity Weight Loss and Detoxification Program. To enroll, contact Michelle Edmonds, a.k.a. the Godmother, at 404-445-8579 or hit them up on Facebook at Serenity Weight Loss. The next voice that you hear will be that of our awesome host.
This is Kim and Kim with Detox Tuesday with Michelle Edmonds. And Edmonds and Michelle, you're going to be so proud of me. I did go and purchase some, I think that was chlorophyll, something like that.
What did you purchase?
Chlorophyll. It helps you with reversing the anemia.
Chlorophyll.
Yes, excellent. I bought some. Yes.
Oh, you did. Excellent.
Yeah,
you
I'm
got
listening.
It in liquid form or capsules?
Oh. I did get. I got the chewable one.
Little chewable chlorophyll?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Oh, well, that's a start, everyone. Start with some chewable chlorophyll, like Kimmy Kim, and then we're going to keep working on it, and you'll graduate later on.
Okay. And then guess what? I did buy some essential oils, and Walmart had, like, all the ones that you recommend in a case for $22.
That's right. Isn't that something, Walmart? Now, you know, that's a shame.
You have to go online, though. It's not
isn't that awesome?
Store.
And they're
yes.
relatively inexperienced, and so you get a nice variety that you can use and start experiment with. That is awesome, Kimmy.
And so I am learning. Everything that you're telling me, I am learning.
That is awesome. Well, everyone, I hope you do the same. Really, it's as simple as just going to Walmart sometimes, or maybe, you know, we can't go to Amazon.com for everything. But I like going local and supporting your local community. And so, yeah, go ahead and just pick up a kit like that. I have one of those too, Kimmy Kim.
Okay.
The kit at Walmart, we have a variety of oils. And we're talking about aromatherapy oils, everyone. And aromatherapy oils, they're healing oils. They're oils because of their aroma have healing property. Now, believe it or not, that's Bible-based. However, it became known as New Age. But
really?
Oh, yes. But that's because, see, we allow so much of what is Bible to be repackaged and renamed.
Mm-hmm.
And then we need to go back and research for ourselves and reclaim it and stop giving all these names to these wonderful God-given things, such as aroma, and nobody can claim that, Kimmy Kim, but God. Come on now.
You got to give God some credit, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. You mean he can't invent awesome aroma of lilac and lavender? Come on, y'all. That's not new. That's not new age. That's God. And yeah. So we're going to get started. And that, everyone who have just tuned in for the first time, we are a mind-body-spirit program. We are Detox Tuesday. We're here every Tuesday between 9 and 10. And we just have a good time. But we're serious in our message that in order to get well, there needs to be a mind-body-spirit connection. And so my component is Nature Heals, as you might imagine. My name is Michelle Edmonds, and I am a counseling psychologist and a trained nutritionist. And so being on the podium with a pastor is just wonderful for me. And then today, I'm going to actually start by reading a scripture, and I'm going to be talking from the Bible today about healing crystals. Now, this is another area, Kimmy Kim, that's considered New Age. But now we're talking Revelation 21. Now, for all the people who think crystals is New Age, well, you better check out Revelation 21 because they be rolling back there. Shoot, I want to get there. They be talking.
I love you, Michelle.
Shoot.
Keep it real. You keep
absolutely.
It real.
Absolutely. Anytime my streets are paved in stones and gold, shoot, that's God. Everyone go with me if you have your Bibles, and if you don't, that's okay. We know we caught you probably at the end of your day, and it's been a busy day. We appreciate that you're even with us at all. But I'm going to be reading from Revelation 21. And if you start, Revelation 21 talks about the 12 crystals, gemstones. They just talk about 12. And listen to this. And the building of the wall, it was made of jasper. And the city was pure gold. Now, anybody with their right mind want to be back there? Like clear glass. Revelation 21:19. Then the foundations of the wall of the city were garnished with all manner of precious stones. The first foundation was jasper. The second was sapphire. The third was chalcedony. The fourth was emerald. Now you're going to notice, everyone, you're going to recognize your birthstone. The fifth was sardonyx. The sixth, sardius. The seventh, chrysolite. The eighth, beryl. The ninth, topaz. Actually, that's the birthstone of November, since we're just about approaching November. The 10th, a chrysoprasus. Chrysoprasus. The 11th was jacinth. And the 12th stone of the foundation of the wall of the city was amethyst. Now, I thought that was really cool. I don't know about y'all. But I thought, you know, we got all these rappers out there, and I don't want to be hating on them because a lot of rappers are really quite good. But we always make fun of everybody wearing all this jewelry and all this bling. And Kim, you know, I did a study of Revelation, of the book of Revelation, specifically the 21st book. And then I expanded and did a study of the entire Bible, what it had to say about gemstones and crystals. Talks about diamonds and gold quite a bit. And I thought, you know, this really needs to be talked about more. Because I have been studying, when I studied nutrition and alternative medicine, we learned a lot about working with crystals and how to heal. It's called energy healing. But then I studied and I realized, well, energy healing is a good term, but it's very, very much rooted in the Bible. So I thought, you know, I wonder if all this bling that we kind of criticize the rappers and the kids in the street for wearing, it has a lot of its foundation from the Bible. This issue of dripping in gold, and it's in the Bible. Now, is it distorted? Yeah, but it's probably not any more distorted than the term New Age. But the point is, it's in the Bible. Now, here is where I want to go with it specifically. If you continue your study, you also will find that each of these gemstones that are mentioned in the Bible have healing properties. And so, for example, the first one that we mentioned, it mentioned jasper. But did you know jasper is known for having healing powers, specifically for healing leaders? Did you know sapphire has the powers for healing the mind and for helping to facilitate intuition? Agate, that's A-G-A-T-E, is known for balancing emotions, both physical and intellectual. Now, just like aromatherapy, and I'm so glad Kim, you brought it up, you can buy a kit of aromatherapy vials and experiment and find out what beautiful fragrances work best for you for centering your body. And let me back up a moment. When we talk about centering your body, we're talking God. God is within us. But we're talking about getting centered so that we experience and operate more from the God within us. Now, that term, it may sound like it's New Agey. Okay. But the term is called chakra. It actually is not really a New Age term. It's actually a very ancient East Indian term. And so when we're talking about healing and getting centered in the body with our energy, we're talking about getting our chakras, our various energy centers. We're talking about getting them in alignment. Chiropractors talk about it all the time, but they use chiropractic talk. And so they talk about aligning your bones. They're talking about getting your energy in alignment. I'm talking about, now, the Bible in Revelation 21 is talking about the building foundations, alignment. I am talking about, when we're talking about mind, body, spirit, we're talking about alignment. The tripart being is alignment. And so God talks about God's force, God's natural force in energy is all about being centered and being focused, balanced. And we've learned that something like gemstones or crystals, yes, the diamonds that you wear on your finger, you know, the rappers were onto something. Isn't that a blip? Ain't that something, Kimmy Kim? I wonder, did the rappers, do they intuitively know this? But gold has healing properties. It has properties attached to it that help to center the body. That help
wow.
to center. Is it, yes, they help to center the energy of the body. So now take some of the knowledge that we're going to study over the next week, this session and next session, and take that now and go back and examine the wrapper, the one that you go, oh, it's not necessary to wear all of that. And that may very well be. But I always believe, Kimmy Kim, nothing is a coincidence. And I am wondering if there's something to that, since it's in the Bible. Gold is calming, and sure enough, rappers wear lots of bling, gold. And so we're going to take today and next to Detox Tuesday to talk about some of the specific healing properties of gemstones. As we find, isn't that awesome? As we find
like that.
In the Bible. It's really an awesome, awesome study. Now, how do I use them? We're going to talk a little bit about how I use them first, because I want you to know why this is such a valuable study. Now, maybe the people who wear all the bling didn't study it, but somebody knew something. Somebody knows something. And so let's take an example. There are, you know, when you hear the line about gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And Kimmy Kim, we referenced that very briefly last time we met. And gold, frankincense, and myrrh were the gifts that were brought. And the reason they were gold, frankincense, and myrrh, they are in the Bible, and gold represents prosperity. It also has healing powers. Here is that gold again, synonymous with bling. Frankincense and myrrh are both herbs, also used as incense. Incense is known as New Age. But incense, frankincense and myrrh goes way, way back. And it was used to symbolize your health and your healing and your peace. Incense is about peace, gold, prosperity, and your health, frankincense and myrrh. Let's talk about some others. Fascinating. We're going to talk about, because I am a counseling psychologist, I happen to like the study of anything that affects the psychology and the way you think. Well, let's take a look at three. Maybe we only get two in tonight, Kimmy Kim, and then we'll do maybe three more next week. Pyrite is a gemstone that's in the Bible. And pyrite is actually a beautiful dark stone. It looks almost like a kohl, gold brownish color. And it's readily available. It's not rare. Now, just like you got your kit of aromatherapy, Kimmy Kim, you can also, everyone listening audience, you can buy a kit of gemstones as well. They're very inexpensive. They look like someone who collects gemstones as a hobby, you know, but they really are designed to understand and get comfortable with their, and we're going to use a term that you may not be familiar with, their vibration. So healing with crystals, because crystals, gemstones, come from the earth, and God made the earth, it is said that the stone that is harvested from the earth, the various colors and the various textures have an energy and a healing energy. So pyrite, not a very well-known name, but listen to what it does. It blocks out negative energy. Now, how would you use it? You would just have the stone in your home. That's it. Nothing spooky.
Wow.
Yeah, nothing spooky, Kimmy Kim. You know, we know. See, we are Christians. We're not doing seance. We're not getting spooky. We're taking what's in the Bible, and then we're seeing how do people who do chakra healing, you heard me mention that name, what do they do with these stones? All they do is they tell you, get comfortable with the stone that makes you feel good, because the stone itself has a vibrational activity from God. Now, if that's true, then various stones, for whatever reason, make you feel more comfortable than others. And so they study and they found, gee, everyone reports when they use pyrite, P-Y-R-I-T-E, they feel more positive. It's also used to heal infectious diseases. You can keep it in your home on your dresser. or you can wear it around your neck. No more spooky, listening audience, than wearing garlic. You've heard of that, right, Kimmy Kim? Wearing garlic around your neck? Did your grandmother ever do that? Ooh, child,
yes,
mine.
Yes.
I was like, get away from me. You know, there's nothing more spooky than that. So what they're saying, rather than you might wear garlic around your neck, you would wear, in a necklace form, pyrite. It is known as a subtle healing and protection from harm and danger. Infectious diseases, and so it's very well used during the winter. Now, psychologically, pyrite relieves anxiety. Now, maybe, listening audience, you're getting a hint to why I started with pyrite. You might be thinking, why didn't she start with gold? Why didn't she call my birthstone out and use topaz first? Nope. We're going to get to those. We're going to make this an ongoing study, and we're going to get through the more interesting stone. But pyrite fascinated me. Because aside from the physical healing of infections and infectious diseases and protection from harm and danger, pyrite psychologically relieves anxiety and frustration. Now, I'm wondering, listening audience, you know something? Since these are natural stones, you're doing nothing with them, nothing at all, but putting them on your dresser or wearing them or carrying them in your purse or wearing a beautiful stone, unpolished, that's been put into a necklace form around your neck. So what if it does work? But then again, what if vitamin C? Oh, Kimmy Kim, what if chlorophyll does work that you just spoke about when we opened the broadcast?
That's
the point.
That's awesome.
That's the point of this study. It doesn't matter. It's a beautiful stone. And if we also feel less anxious, my God, give me a whole bucket full of pyrite. Shoo, you can ship some my way anytime. Listen to this, everyone. Shoo, all this stress and anxiety in the world right now, even listening to our elections, is stressful.
Yes.
I've never seen anything so outrageous. I'm like, you know, maybe they should have some pie right up there on that podium. Listen to this. Again, you'll see why I chose this as the first one, and maybe you'll be the only one as I'm looking at the time. It is helpful for men who feel inferior. Trump. as it strengthens confidence in themselves and their masculinity. But it may be too powerful for macho men, initiating aggression. So it helps women to overcome, listen to this, feelings of inferiority. Pyrite? Well, you see, if you now take it back and examine the fact that there are stones that are mentioned in the Bible. And by the way, Revelation is chock full of study, chock full of information on the value of stones from the earth, gemstones, crystals. And then it's our job now to reference that and study it, roll up our sleeves and unpeel the layers of the onion to see, what do people who do holistic healing use these stones for? And this is one thing that pyrite is known for. And yet you could probably buy some pyrite, again, from a place that provides gemstones for very little, because all you're doing is buying a rock. Now, some of the crystals are expensive. Of course, buying gold is expensive. But a lot of the gemstones, which are used for healing, are very inexpensive because they're plentiful. God made an abundance of them. And so pyrite treats bones, stimulates cellular formation. It helps to facilitate sleep. It helps gastric upset. It helps strengthen the digestive tract. It neutralizes ingested toxins. It benefits the respiratory system, boosts oxygen in the bloodstream. And therefore, it helps to alleviate asthma and bronchitis. And if you have one of those ailments, they're saying the best position of all, rather than around your neck, is simply to place the stone under your pillow. That's all you need to do. Isn't that beautiful, Kimmy?
That is beautiful. That is
all
so beautiful.
Need, and that has to be God. We're going to do one more, and then we're going to close out, and we'll do a few more during our next week of study. I'd like to go to Jade. Jade is a symbol of purity. Everyone knows jade. Jade is green, very often worn as a ring. But you know I like this. You know I'm Serenity Radio Network, right?
And exactly.
So jade is a symbol of purity and serenity. It's very valued in the East, as in Asia, and it signifies wisdom and tranquility. As you know, everyone must know that Asians wear a lot of jade jewelry. So that's really nothing new that it's popular in the East. Jade is also associated with the heart. Remember we used the term chakra. Chakra is just a term to refer to energy meridians in the body. So the heart chakra is the most affected by jade. It helps to increase love and nurturing. Now, Kimmy Kim, now go back and think about, let me continue, and I want to ask you a question.
Okay.
Psychologically, jade stabilizes the personality, and it helps to integrate, listen to this, everyone, it helps to integrate the mind and body. It promotes self-sufficiency. Jade releases negative thoughts, and it soothes the mind. It is known as the dream stone. It is believed to attract good luck and friendship. Now, have you ever been around Asians who are wearing a lot of jade jewelry? Have you ever noticed that? Or you go into a Chinese restaurant and you'll notice jade fixtures?
I have no. Wow.
You have not noticed that?
No.
Well, they do. And next time you go into a Chinese restaurant, I'm talking about a really nice one. And maybe I should say you might find it more in Japanese restaurants. You'll notice jade fixtures, just like we have ceramic fixtures in our home. You'll notice a lot of use of jade around the restaurant because it's used to attract, to create an environment of harmony, and it's believed to attract good luck and friendship. And that's why many restaurants have jade in their restaurants. Is attracting good luck, which we don't really believe in luck. So we're going to say prosperity and friendship. So, and that is typically why Asians will have jade in their restaurants and their place of business. Now these stones, I'd like for your homework, everyone. No big deal. Don't make it, I don't want you to go and write a dissertation. But go ahead and open the book of Revelation 21. Just read the entire book of 21 for me. Then that's your homework. Then what I want you to do, I want you to pay attention to the pulse. We're going to use the healing energy in the Mind, Body, Spirit Facebook group. Please go to the Mind, Body, Spirit Detox Facebook group. You'll see the energy healing bulletin board. And I'm going to be posting information that supports what I've said tonight and that's going to stir you up and make you want to know more and research more and learn more so that if you want to explore this very, very effective but different holistic form of healing that is very much mind, body, spirit, you can do so inexpensively. So check the bulletin board throughout the week, everyone, on the Mind Body Facebook group. You can hit me up also and call me at 404-445-8579. If you also want to do a detox, what I love is while you're exploring these healing modalities, like your chlorophyll that Kimmy Kim got, be it chewables, doesn't matter. You want get the liquid. I like that, too. You know, everyone knows I like liquid. And then you get your aromatherapies and you start sprinkling them around and finding out which ones really, really make you flow with you. And then add to that a study or just a conversation, just paying more attention to the wonderful world of gemstones, crystals. Man, Kimmy Kim, by the time the holidays get here and the end of the year, we're going to be so calm and cool and collective. Ain't nobody, everybody going to wonder, what did you do? What you been doing? What you been doing?
Amen. Amen. I believe that.
Oh, yes. And so I just love talking about this, as you can tell. Mm. We're at the bottom of the hour. Gotta go. Time goes so quickly, everyone. We appreciate you, how you come out and you support us. We thank you. Again, my name is Michelle Edmonds. I am the author of Serenity Weight Loss and Detoxification Program. Start your internal detox, please, for the fall. Come on, get it done for the end of the year. Go ahead and get some chlorophyll like Kimmy Kim.
Yes.
And then you meet us here next week so we can talk a little bit more about healing with crystals. Thanks so much. We love you. God bless. Thanks, Kimmy Kim.
Be blessed. Love you, Michelle.
Bye-bye.
I was created for was created for. Oh, I was created for. No, I believe in God. I was created for.
When you don't go to Geico.com, car insurance can be confusing. Like Swedish techno confusing.
Bark, bark, meow, meow. Dance with me, purple cow. Bark, bark, meow, meow. Ooh, you lovely cow.
Geico makes it easy. With 24/7 access, all you have to do is go to Geico.com and you could save money on car insurance. It just makes sense. Unlike, you know.
Dance with me, purple cow. I like your moves.
Jimmy John's America's number one sandwich delivery, fast ed speaking. I'm on my way.
I'm in the backyard here, Ed.
Wow, you are fast.
Yes, sir, freaky fast and freaky good, but I gotta say, I've never delivered to a dude in a doghouse.
Well, I'm definitely in the doghouse.
I thought in the doghouse was just an expression, a figure of speech.
Well, the doghouse is a very real place.
How long are you condemned to your canine quarters?
Too soon to tell, but on the bright side.
The doghouse has a bright side.
Yeah, the wife can't throw a lamp this far.
Oh, I guess she's been working out.
Order Jimmy John's sandwich delivery today. Jimmy John's, freaky fast, freaky fresh.